What's going on, everybody? I just wanted to show y'all my new purchase. I bought the cheapest 2001 Toyota Camry out there. And it only cost me $200. But the reason I'm doing this video, because I wanted to show y'all something here. This Toyota Camry only cost me $200, but it has a perfect engine, perfect transmission. They put so much work into the motor transmission. I mean, you can even look right here. Brand new shocks and everything. I mean, like, perfect. So, I'm making this video so I can show y'all that you ain't always got to have the prettiest vehicle to have the best vehicle. Because this thing is sure enough ain't pretty. But look at the inside, y'all. I mean, inside not bad at all. I mean, inside not bad. Look at them seats. Almost look like they never been set in. But when you look on the outside, it don't look like it look on the inside. But it's also that Florida sun, too. That Florida sun will kill a vehicle. With the quickness, it'll kill a vehicle. But I spent $200 on this, y'all. I'm talking about perfect motor, perfect transmission. Thing shifts so pretty. Like I'm in a Porsche or something. So, you know, and I look at this. I mean, look at this paint. Now, of course, I got to sand this down, prime it, and then go take it to get it painted. But, I mean, you know, it's $200 car. What you expect? But this motor right here, this is what I'm talking about. That motor, man, that motor rides so good, y'all. I mean, so good. I mean, it's a lot. I mean, still got a whole lot of original parts on it that I'm going to have to swap out just because this car been sitting for over 6 years. So it has a lot of original parts on it that I, of course, got to just swap out just because one day, eventually, the alternator going to go out, starter going to go out, you know, stuff like that. But, I mean, it's still ride. I hit the highway, man, this thing rides so quiet. AC work, heat work, lights work. Blinkers work, cruise control work, everything work. And you know, it only has 135,000 miles on it, but I had to change out the dashboard because the speedometer stopped working. So the new one, it says more miles, but the original one says only 130,000 miles, and it ride like it barely has any miles on it. No leaks whatsoever, no oil nowhere. I mean, perfect vehicle, y'all. Now, like I said, this thing ain't pretty. Alright, this thing ain't pretty. The ugliest girl you seen in high school look better than this. But the point is, this thing gonna get you to A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now, I live in Jacksonville, so I drive around North Florida a lot, doing little runs in here and there, going from studio to studio, because I write music. That's my, you know, one of my main things other than investing in stocks and trying to build my YouTube channel. But I don't ride my Benzes around town a lot. I buy little cheap cars and I put a bunch of miles on them because I don't like to put miles on my Mercedes Benzes. So this is a perfect car, man, for y'all. If y'all, even if y'all got a regular job and y'all just, you know, trying to get the A and B, you don't always have to go broke spending millions and, you know, well, I'm saying millions, I'm exaggerating, but you don't always have to go broke with having these high finance charges, getting loans, and paying these high car notes for cars that's going to depreciate anyway. I see so many people paying $400 and $500 car notes every month on top of full coverage insurance, and I'm like, for what? A car that's just going to depreciate? And if you keep that car till you pay it off, that car ain't going to be worth what you paid for it. You just lost money. Now, this car cost me $200. And if I keep this car for 3 years, I'm going to make over $60,000 on a car that I only paid $200 for. Now, that's a profit that I can believe in, and that's a profit that I can get behind. So it's all about being economical. It's always about monetizing everything. This car can monetize because I only spent $200 on a car with a perfect engine and transmission. And I'm going to make a lot of YouTube videos, you know, showing how to fix a lot of things on this Camry. So it's going to really help me. Help me build my YouTube channel. Help me build my fans base. I'm trying to get 10,000 subscribers, man. So y'all make sure y'all subscribe and help me out, man. Share it a lot. So anybody with a Toyota Camry, I'm going to be doing a lot of work on this. And you know what I mean? Just stick with me. Now, that's a lot of things like, you know, this light. I got to run to the junkyard to get that. I got the brand new hood caps. They in the trunk. So let me show y'all the trunk. You know what I mean? We had to put new stuff on. So the body, horrible. But that motor and transmission, perfect. Ride so smooth, ride like a brand new Toyota Camry. You know what I mean? So don't always look at the outside and be shallow and assume that the car raggedy because the outside bad. That's not how it works. You know what I mean? The outside can look any kind of way it want to look. But if that car ride like a brand new Lexus, that's what kind of car you want. And this car rides like a brand new Lexus. So, but here go the trunk, y'all. Check out that trunk. See, your trunk, I got a brand new tire. I just got to put it on the old spare tire, but I got a brand new tire here. I got all the brand new hood caps for it. I just got to stick them on. So, you know, I got a whole lot of stuff for it, man. And this right here, this is the old dash that I was telling you about. Now, this one shows that it only has 130-something thousand miles on it. The new dash, it has like 202 because the new dash, you know, the mileage won't change out. But this speedometer, the speedometer on that went bad. So I had to change that out and the gas needle. So I changed it out with the new one. So the new one, it works, but the new one says a different mileage. But this one, that's the original one, and it says 130-something thousand miles. But trunk work, man, everything worked good on it. And yeah, I'm gonna make a lot of videos with this, man. So y'all please subscribe, tell everybody about this channel, because I'm trying to blow it up, trying to get to 10,000 subscribers. And y'all tell me what y'all think, man. The cheapest Toyota Camry in the country, I only paid $200 for a car that's gonna probably ride for the next 5 to 6 years and give me zero problems, because it's a Toyota. Toyotas and Hondas last forever. Especially if you just do regular maintenance on it, they really gonna last forever. So yeah, man, you know, good. I think it was the best deal ever, you know what I mean? So y'all tell me what y'all think, man. Do y'all think the body is what's important, or is that motor and transmission what's important to y'all? Because you can always paint the body and fix whatever, but if that motor and transmission bad, who cares about what the car look like? Now that's for me, but y'all tell me what y'all think. Are y'all embarrassed to have a nice, because I got a bunch of Benzes at the house, and I barely even drive those, because I like driving these. I like buying little, you know, little quick, little A, B, C, D get around cars, and I like riding those. I only drive my Benzes when I'm with a girl. That's the only time I drive my Benzes. Other than that, I drive these kind of cars, because I ain't trying to really, you know, put miles on the Benzes and wear them out. And I don't mind. I'll pull up right in front of any building with this, like I'm in a brand new Rolls Royce. So I don't have no problem. But tell me what y'all think. Do y'all think it's cool to be paying high car notes and only having one vehicle in your parking lot that you putting a bunch of miles on, and once you pay it off, it ain't gonna be worth nothing, and you paying all them high car notes? Or do you feel like you can buy one of these and only pay one time, and that car gonna get you to work every single day for the next 2.5-3 years, and it's gonna make you a lot of money, and you gonna be out of your pocket zero, because you ain't gotta pay full coverage insurance, and you ain't gotta pay high car notes. So all of that money that you could have been paying, that's in your bank account while you still making money, because this car's still reliable and it's still getting you to A, B, C, and D every single day. But y'all tell me what y'all think, man, and thank y'all for watching. Please subscribe, and like I said, I'm gonna do a whole lot to just fix on it, and I'm gonna post it on the channel, and I'm gonna have a lot of videos with this. I might paint it, I might not. But I'm gonna definitely put the hood caps back on it and redo the tent and get that headlight fixed. And that's about it, man. I'm just gonna ride it. Ride it till it falls apart, and that's gonna be a long time, because Toyotas last forever. Alright, so thank y'all for watching, man. Please subscribe, share this with anybody, and y'all tell me what y'all think. Alright, do y'all think the body is more important than the engine and transmission? Or do y'all think that y'all just want to buy a brand new car because you want to floss every day of the week? You know, you tell me what y'all think, all right? So thank y'all for watching. Please subscribe. Peace.